Sometime in 2018, I started seeing ads for the smirking bald dude pointing a gun directly at my face, and without realizing it, had stumbled across one of the coolest TV shows nobody was talking about. And it was cool in this sort of lo-fi underground way, the same way shows like It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia and The Whitest Kids You Know are cool, where you can tell it's a labor of love by a small group of underdogs trying to make something special.
Turn around and say it again! Turn around and say it again! Turn around, say it
Will
again!
Will you please be quiet?
John, that is the President of the United States.
I don't care who it is, he's ruining Hamlet.
Oh, now you fucked up!
And this is absolutely the case with FX's Australian crime dramedy, Mr. Inbetween, which follows Ray Shoesmith, a hitman who has a unique way of doing things.
Wash your hands, you dirty prick.
At a first glance, the show just seems like it's the hitman with a heart trope that's obviously popular. But what makes Mr. Inbetween so remarkable is how it depicts the two worlds that the main character is stuck between, his world of violence and his world of peace. We spend the majority of each episode literally following Ray around and seeing how he spends his days. And what's clear from the first episode is just how normal Ray's life is. He plays video games when he's bored, he gets nervous meeting new people, he helps raise his kid with his ex-wife, and when he's not helping his family and friends, he's making bodies disappear.
Dig.
Who's paying you?
And the show doesn't go about this angle as other similar shows do, as a sort of cat and mouse game where the thrill is watching Ray struggle with balancing his life or worrying about him getting caught. That's not really a problem for Ray, and it's not an excuse to just watch some guy act like a badass for every episode. I mean, there is plenty of that, but none of that's the point of the show. Instead, we're given a selection of bite-sized moments out of Ray's daily life, which give us an insight into what kind of a hitman Ray is. You can actually see what I'm talking about with the first two scenes of the series. In the first, Ray, after finding out a fellow criminal has ripped off his boss, pushes said criminal off a stairwell, nearly killing them as a way of teaching them a lesson. And in the very next scene, we see he's in the shower and helping a ladybug safely exit. I know this is watching stuff 101, but really, what does that tell us about Ray before we know anything else about him? That he views a bug as deserving more respect than a criminal who steals from his friends? Was he willing to risk killing somebody to teach them a lesson? Has he done this before? How many times? Okay, here's another. In this scene, he's making this dude dig his own grave. I mean, yeah, that's really bad.
Nah, mate. What are you doing? The dude's supposed to go outside the hole, pal.
But in the very next scene, he's also worrying about lying to his daughter when she asks about whether Santa's real.
Santa's like a myth.
What's that?
It's like a tradition.
So he is real?
No, he's not. No.
So where do presents come from?
I buy them.
So why'd you lie about that?
Good question. I mean, I don't even know where the whole Santa thing comes from. And what it's got to do with Jesus being born.
It's a really interesting slow burn of a character study into the life of someone who feels so real. And as every critic points out who's seen the show, it's a lot to do with the lead actor slash writer, Scott Ryan. I looked up to see what other projects he's been involved in, and what I found out is, besides this show, he's only worked on one other project. In the early 2000s, Scott Ryan and his friends made a short film which featured Scott playing the same character, Ray, but it was done as a sort of mockumentary style, sort of like an Australian Trailer Park Boys.
What's that? What do you call that? You call that digging?
No, I'm breaking...
What's that?
I'm breaking the shit off the edges.
You're breaking the shit off the edges. You break the shit off the edges, we'll be here till fucking Christmas.
And after screening the 30-minute short at the St. Kilda Film Festival, producer-director Nash Egerton helped Ryan by giving him a budget of $330,000 to expand it into an 85-minute feature film, which was released in 2005 as The Magician. And for the next 10-plus years, two of them would shop the idea of adapting the film as a series to various networks, with the caveat that Scott Ryan remain in the role of Ray, and that the two of them maintain complete creative control. And fortunately, it paid off when FX picked it up and the first season debuted to critical praise in September of 2018. And honestly, I think it's because of those caveats. Scott stars and writes every episode, Nash directs every episode, and the result is that personal crafted feeling that so many other shows seem to lack despite having bigger budgets and way more famous people involved. So that's why I'm making this video. The second season is currently airing, and if I can direct more people to watching a show that deserves your attention in this crazy age of streaming, I'll have done my part. Taking this sort of subdued approach to a genre that relies on action to hold people's attention is kind of a risk. But for God's sakes, these seasons are only like 6 episodes long, and those episodes are only like 25 minutes each. And yet, for being so short, this series has a really cinematic feel. There's a little bit of Richard Linklater's meandering slice of life pacing. There's a little bit of Nicholas Winding Refn's unflinching look at the life of a criminal. So if you feel like you're overwhelmed with too many shows and want something to dip your toe into, I say check out Mr. In-Between on FX. I'm not being paid by this. I just think it's a really cool show, and nothing is worse than a special show being canceled before its time because it didn't find a big enough audience. That's not true. There's plenty of other worse things. Apparently all the bees are dying. That sucks.